Okay, today is the 22nd of January 2021. This is intraday live update. We are in the middle of the Australian and New Zealand stock market trading session. Now, a couple of notable events today. Now, first of all, Lynas, which is one of the largest rare earth producers in the world and definitely the biggest and possibly the only significant one in Australia. Now, you can see from the chart that it has been rising quite rapidly over the past month or so. Now, that is mainly driven by the increasing forecasted demand for lithium and rare earth, because the world is making ever more electric vehicles, and to put even more demand on their product, a few Australian power generators have announced the plans to build giant batteries in order to store some energy deal with the fluctuating spot market price. So those kind of projects, we are talking about storing like hundreds of thousands of megawatts of energy for as much as 8 to 10 hours. So those will place a huge demand on the rare earth that's produced, including those produced by Lynas. And also, it has been announced today that Lynas is going to go forward with a project in Texas, United States. Now, that project is has huge potential because it would be able to produce rare earth in the United States and presumably primarily sold into the US markets. And regardless of which administration, the former one or the current one, you would think that they are likely to be granted the necessary approval, because this is considered a strategic industry for the United States, for sure. I mean, you can expect that the current administration might have higher standards on environmental protection, but definitely not enough to actually can the project. It's a matter of how you mitigate the environmental damage after you are done with the extracting of those rare earths, but it's not a deal breaker for sure. And the fact that it's actually in Texas probably would mean that the state government would be relatively friendly towards these type of like polluting projects. Yeah, so this is what's been driving Lynas for the better part of the whole year, really. Who knows, it has the potential to go even higher if the demand is keeping up, and also crucially if they are able to keep up on the supplying side of things. Now, yeah, some of our Malaysian audience may have mixed feelings about Lynas, because they are doing a fair amount of refining of the rare earth inside Malaysia, and some locals are not particularly comfortable with the environmental mitigation measures. So yeah, it's an ongoing issue, but yeah, again, probably not enough to make Lynas to depart Malaysia for good. Yeah, can't see that happening.